this is, here's the argument for it. They're in a situation where they just bought this organization for $4 billion. They need to make money, motherfucker. So if they're going to have Tyron Woodley fight Nate Diaz, like, hey, that's going to do some pay-per-view numbers. And it will. That's an interesting fight. I like to see it. I like to see how Nate deals with the biggest, fastest welterweight in the division. The biggest knockout artist welterweight in the division. I mean, there's no doubt about it. Tyron Woodley is a tank. He's a tank who throws fucking missiles your way. Boom, boom. And he's gotten very tactical. People got mad at him for those two Wonder Boy fights. But I suggest that they don't truly appreciate what those fights represented. They represented extreme consequences for any mistake. You're fighting a guy who's like one of the best counter-strikers on the planet Earth in Wonder Boy. He's one of the sneakiest, slipperiest strikers in the sport. He moves like a world champion karate guy who also has takedown defense. And he's got a ton of experience in MMA now. And he just fights weird. He throws front leg roundhouse kicks to your face. He jumps in and hits you with shots you don't see coming because he like has that blitz karate style that he employs sometimes. Very difficult to hit. His hands are always down low. And Tyron managed to not just beat him, and they were boring fights. I'm not going to lie to you. They were boring fights, but they weren't boring to me while they were happening. It was boring in terms of the overall result because it was a 5-round decision where not a lot of exchanges took place. But it wasn't boring when I was watching it, and this is why. It's because now that you know that how it ended, you'll just sit through the fight and go, oh my God, this is boring. But when...
I can tell, since you've chosen to leave me frozen.